It is, as Aaron said, little boy, big desert. And according to the UN worker who took that picture, according to him, that little boy's name is Marwan. He's four, and he lives on the other side of that big desert, which now happens to be arguably the worst place in the world, Syria, a place where men from the government fill giant barrels with explosives and scrap metal and rusted cutlery. They light a fuse, they kick it out of a helicopter into the neighborhoods below. And the guys fighting those guys, it's like a Star Wars cantina of terrorists and jihadists and freedom fighters, impossible to tell the good guys from the bad. So it's no wonder that almost 2.5 million people have fled Syria, including this little guy who somehow crossed that big desert to get to the safety of Jordan, somehow got separated from his family, and somehow, after 3 years of trying to digest the horror show of this war, that's the photograph that absolutely jammed me inside. And granted, it's not as iconic, it's not as horrific as this one. Her name is Kim, and when she was 9, South Vietnamese planes accidentally napalmed her village, burned off her clothes. But after 17 surgeries, she grew up and started an American foundation to help children scarred by war. She's beautiful, right? So if Kim can get out of that hell, maybe there's hope for Marwan. But where's his family? A wave of concern followed that picture all around the world, so the UN worker started tweeting updates. He had been reunited shortly after crossing the border. But how long was he out there alone? Well, photos were examined and enhanced, and you can see him straggling, separated but not alone, which brings a bit of relief, followed by conspiracy theories. Is this another attempt at propaganda for a march to intervention against Syria? If so, your image fails, someone named Bruno tweeted at the UN. And it's funny how history repeats. Thanks to his White House tape recorder, we know that Richard Nixon, when he saw those pictures of Kim burned from napalm, said, "I wonder if that was fixed," as if anyone needed to manufacture the horror of Vietnam. So the insinuation from this little corner of the internet is that Marwan is sort of some sort of wag the dog prop. You remember the movie where the White House has Dustin Hoffman, the director, use an actress in a soundstage and a computer-generated cat to beat the drums of war? Well, after a dozen years of Americans dying in the desert, it's going to take a lot more than Marwan to convince any of us it's a smart move to invade Syria these days. The Obama administration, they are out of ideas, frustratingly out of ideas. And as long as Russia keeps propping up the chinless eye doctor turned tyrant, Bashar al-Assad, the bullets will keep flying, families will keep fleeing. But that doesn't mean we can't rally around the survivors. And I talked to a brain scientist today who said it helps for us to actually focus on the little stories to make sense of mass tragedies. Kind of the way Malala sort of distills the fight against religious madness. When she was 11, she began blogging about life under the Pakistani Taliban. Just 14 when they shot her in the head for that. Of course, she survived, became a symbol of strength. And where was she yesterday? Well, she was on the Syria-Jordan border, greeting refugees like the Marwan's family, helping carry their stuff, helping them grieve. So while diplomats argue in Abu Dhabi tonight about stopping this war, I guess all we can do is root for the Malalas and the Kims and the Marwans and the people out there devoting their lives to trying to help them.
Yeah, it's pretty amazing when you look at that picture, how when you pulled out, you know, it said, and as you said, not necessarily that anyone was trying to mislead, but it did show a different story.
Yeah. And it's interesting to note that neither Bashar al-Assad or any of his top deputies, they claim to care about the Syrians. None of them have visited any of these massive refugee camps in Lebanon or Turkey or there in Jordan.
Yeah.
It's just going to go on.